In this video, I'm going to show you how to extract an image embedded in a layout in a FileMaker solution back onto the desktop of your machine. So the most common reason for this is you've inherited a FileMaker system and there's an icon in the system that you want to modify. Say you want to change the color of it, clean it up a little bit, what have you. And you want to open up in a image editing application like Photoshop. Well, you got to be able to extract that image and get it out of FileMaker. However, when you embed an image in FileMaker, you don't have the ability with FileMaker's interface to be able to export that image back out. So let me go ahead and show you what we can do to get that image back out. I'm gonna open up this FileMaker system here. This is a demo file from a previous video we made. What I want to do is I want to extract out the DB Services logo here in the corner. And just to show you that you can't get it out of the file, if I go in here and I right click, there's no export option anywhere. And if I try to drag it out of FileMaker, nothing's happening. I can't drag it out there. You see when I get out of the document window, my mouse icon is not a plus, so there's no drag and drop capability for an image here in layout mode. So what you do is you can extract this from a DDR. DDRs have a text representation of the image. It's a hexadecimal representation. You can take that and you can use an online converter to convert it back to a binary file and save it to your desktop. So I'm going to go ahead and show you the steps for this. So the first step here is to create a DDR. You can just create the DDR as is if you want, but it's going to be a little bit more difficult to find the actual image object in the DDR if you have a bunch of other objects on the same layout. So what I like to do is I like to make a brand new FileMaker file. So I'm going to go up here, File, New Database. So just a brand new empty FileMaker file. I'm going to name it temp here. Let me save it. Okay, so we got that open. What I'm going to do is I'm going to right click and copy the image from the existing system and I'm going to paste it into this new blank file. And then I'm going to save the blank file, and I'm going to run a DDR on this blank file. So this accomplishes two things. One, the DDR will just, it'll run really fast. It'll be, you know, instantaneous to run it versus an existing system. If you have a big system with 500, 600 layouts, I mean, you're going to be sitting there for a good 2 to 5 minutes waiting for the DDR to run. So this saves you time. And because it's a blank layout, the only object on it is the image you're trying to extract, so it's very easy to find that image in the DDR. So let's go ahead and run the DDR here. So tools, DDR, the database design report. You cannot run a DDR. The only place you can run a DDR is with FileMaker Advanced. If you just have Pro, regular Pro, you won't be able to run a DDR. So this technique requires FileMaker Pro Advanced. Okay, so in the DDR menu here, I want to go ahead and just run it on the temp file. So I'm going to uncheck this the existing file. And the big thing here is to select XML as the format that I want to run. The HTML version does not have the hexadecimal representation of the image. You want the XML. So I'm going to go ahead and press create here, and I'm going to save it in a folder. Okay, it's already done. So we go and open up the DDR here with a text editor. In this case, I'm on a Mac. I'm using a text editor called Text Wrangler. So I'm gonna open up the temp files XML. You don't want the summary. The summary doesn't have the image in it. You want the actual file, the XML file that has the name of the blank file you made. Okay, so in here, what you want to do is you want to search for the layout that has the image in it. In this case, the layout's called temp. It's the same name as the file I made. So I'm gonna do a search here, and you'll know you found it because the name is on the right side of the tag. There's a layout tag here, and then you have the name of the layout, which is this is the layout I'm looking for. So I found the layout tag, and in here, the next thing you're looking for a graphic object tag, which is this guy right here. It sticks out pretty well because in that tag you'll see a huge string of letters and numbers going out to the right and to infinity here, and it's pretty long because this is the actual image that you're looking for, and it's a hexadecimal representation. So you can see it's a very long string, but this is the image we're looking for. Sometimes FileMaker has multiple hex data, really long strings for one image, and that just depends on the image type that you embed into the layout. In this case, there's only one type, and that's the PNG right here, PNG type. And that's the one we want. That's what we originally inserted into the layout. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to double click on the hexadecimal data here, and I'm going to copy it to my clipboard. And then I'm going to go to an online hexadecimal to binary converter, which in this case we're using the itools.org converter. Then I'm going to, on the top right here, you want to make sure you've selected the direct input so you can just paste the hexadecimal into the field. And then you're going to want to make sure you've checked this box here. If you don't have it checked, it'll say no output. You don't want this. You want to make sure it's checked and it says yes, download. And then all you got to do is press the hex to binary button, and you'll see right here it has saved a file to your desktop called bind2hex.dat, and that is your image. All you need to do, we're going to show it in Finder here, all you need to do is rename it to you just rename it so it makes sense to you. In this case, I'll just call it DB services logo.png. And the big thing is to rename the file extension to match the type of image. In this case, it was a PNG, so I want to make sure I name it .png at the end. And tell Finder, it's a PNG. And if I double click on it, there we go. We have our original image, and it's extracted off FileMaker. Now I can open it up in Photoshop and do what I want with it. That's it.